Oh my goodness. Oh man. Hi guys, welcome back to our drone channel. Today, deep in the forest with the DJI Mini 4 Pro, because we are about to do a stress test of the obstacle avoidance. Let's see how the DJI Mini 4 Pro can handle trees, branches, and stuff like this. And maybe there's a crash, maybe not. Let's see, this is a stress test. If you like what you see, then subscribe.
All right, let's first take a look at where we can find the sensor settings. At the top of the screen, we see a red circle with two arrows. This indicates to us that the sensors are currently disabled in all directions. This is mainly because the drone is still on ground. Clicking on it will give us detailed information. Forward and backward unavailable, left and right unavailable, and up and down also unavailable. Let's now click on the three dots in the top right corner. In the Safe tab, we find Flight Assistance at the top and below Obstacle Avoidance action. In my case, they are currently disabled. Let's choose Bypass first. Now we can already see in the small picture above what the drone will do, namely avoid obstacles. Additionally, the menu below has expanded. Now we see the Bypass option. Here we find Normal and Nifty. Below that, we can also choose whether obstacles in the radar map should be displayed as a live view, which is, by the way, a pretty cool thing. If we click on Nifty, we select a smart avoidance method that flies smoother maneuvers but increases the risks of hitting obstacles. So let's leave that for today. Try it out yourself and write in the comments which method you prefer. Lastly, we can choose Brake. As the name suggests, the drone stops upon hitting an obstacle. Okay, let's do our first test with Bypass. One can clearly see here that obstacle detection is working. On one hand, the sensor symbol at the top edge is white, and on the other hand, we see the oval circle in the center of the screen. The orange and red colors indicates where obstacles are and how close they are to the drone. Alright, let's position the Mini 4 Pro. The goal is an uninterrupted straight flight through the forest. Also noticeable are the red areas directly in the field of view. We fly directly toward the tree. The Mini 4 Pro adeptly avoids to the right and then encounters problems as more obstacles appear. Moving sideways to the left resolves the issue. The invasive maneuver was flawless. Next is a bush that offers no option. The software should make the decision to interrupt the flight in any case. However, it does not, and thus the Mini 4 Pro enters the area of small branches which are barely detected by the sensors. Well, the result is a crash. Nothing serious happens, so let's continue right away. This time, we perform steering maneuvers and not rely solely on the software's decision. However, the goal is to fly into dense areas where many smaller branches appear. As can be seen, this is pretty successful because the lighting conditions provide good contrast. The evasive maneuvers are good, also sometimes very close in some situations. Let's continue. Slight change of course, so that the sun blinds a bit from the front. A bit more tricky to handle. Okay, we can see the many small branches. However, the drone seems to be unsure. Eventually, another collision occurs and the Mini 4 Pro falls to the ground. This time, however, it has landed a bit clumsy on its nose. The gimbal needs to be recalibrated. The DJI FlyApp shows error code 40027 calibrate gimbal. This is quickly done through the internal function. Cam is booming a bit, then we can continue right away. Alright, for the upcoming flight, we'll now set the sensors to brake. This means that the drone won't evade obstacles but will stop before reaching them. We won't strictly fly straight ahead but simulate a normal flight with steering maneuvers. The trees in the forest are very close together. Gaps range from half a meter to about a meter. So far, the flight has been flawless and the DJI Mini 4 Pro smoothly navigates between the trees and branches. A slight course correction to the left so that we have the sun in the back. The gaps between the trees here are very large, so definitely no issues expected. And another swing to the right to fly into an area where the trees are much more challenging because the gap's getting smaller. Well, the drone also passes through this area without any problems. So far so good, no tree was yet close enough for the drone to stop. Nevertheless, you can clearly see how close we are flying past the obstacles. We can still see clearly from the semicircular circle in the field of view that the sensors are functioning as expected. Slight course correction and now heading directly towards the large tree in front of us. As proof that the sensors are indeed active, we will now fly towards the tree. And voila, in the last few meters it approaches slowly before it stops completely. Let's take a look at the whole thing from a third person perspective. Obstacles ahead, drone detects and stops. And another example flight with the bypass function. Obstacle ahead, drone detects and successfully avoids. And the same again during backward flight. Here too, successful evasion occurs. Okay, as mentioned earlier, there is the radar function that provides you with the live detection of obstacles around the drone. If you have active sensors, simply tap on the small blue arrow at the bottom left corner and the radar will open. I'll demonstrate how well this works and how helpful it is in the following footage. Orange dots and lines indicate obstacles that are moderately far away, and red lines indicate close obstacles. As we fly closer to the trees and bushes, you can see that the drone creates a 360-degree image. Now we are quite close in the thicket. You can see that the lines appear intensely red, essentially forming a band around the drone. At this position, continuing the flight is absolutely impossible without crashing. Lastly, I'll show you how helpful the so-called vision assist is. Since we already know that the sensors are nothing more and nothing less than small visual cameras, we can also control them accordingly. So if we are not sure how close an obstacle is to the drone, we can simply take a look now. However, caution is still advised. The sensors are black and white cameras with very low resolution. This means that the image we see is not particularly sharp. We can view all four sides of the drone, left, right, front and back. Depending on the direction we move the drone, the corresponding flight direction image will be displayed automatically. In our example, we can see the branches and trees very clearly. However, it should now be clear to everyone why you can't rely on the sensors 100%. Due to the low resolution, smaller details such as leaves, blades of grass or even small branches are lost and thus not detected.
Well, that was a pretty nice testing day today. I was quite positively surprised how good these obstacle avoidance sensors are working in such a difficult terrain. When choosing the braking method, how the software was deciding if you can go through the gap or stop right in front of the obstacle. And the decisions taken from the software and therefore the drone did was very, very well, and there was no mistake at all. But in terms of the bypass function, this is a kind of bit strange because the software and therefore the drone is doing decisions which sometimes do not make sense. So nevertheless, don't rely to 100% on your obstacle avoidance sensors. As you have seen, there could be issues and problems as not everything is detected very well. Make your own decision, but I can recommend you to always check the surrounding. Okay guys, that's it pretty much for today. Hope you enjoyed the video and learned a little bit about the obstacle avoidance sensors of your Mini 4 Pro. We'll catch you in the next video. Enjoy the day and don't forget, life's too short to be angry. Okay, thanks for watching. Have a good day. See you. Bye bye.